Good evening, TheoTrade. This is Corey Rosenblum. You're watching the Theo Dantley video for the 3rd of March, 2020. And we had quite a few surprises in today's session, as Don's been reminding us, any point in time, the Fed was likely to come out with a surprise emergency rate cut. That happened today. That's bullish. It sent the stock market to new intraday highs. It sent us back above the 3100 level in the S&P futures, but as discussed in the live sessions in the main room and elsewhere, that was the high of the day. So that was the danger. If the Fed did intervene, did cut rates, and the market shrugged it off as if it never happened, that's where we are. And as Don's video last night, and the selling is not over, that's true. And we still think the selling is not over, because if the market is going to shrug off Fed intervention and Fed policy and Fed rate cuts, especially a 0.50, a 50 basis cut point, well, that puts us in a very dangerous position for the markets. The last time we saw this type of action was in 2008, and that was right at the time that Lehman went under. So the Fed doesn't cut rates to be fun or to be bullish. They cut rates because they see the future being worse than the present, and that unprecedented or reactionary monetary policy is necessary to get those dark spots in the economy or bad financial times out of the way. But if the market doesn't respond, going back to 2008, the Fed cut rates many, many times, all the way through 2008, sometimes surprising with a 0.5 or sometimes 0.75 basis cut, and that didn't stop the bleeding in the market until March of 2009. So we'll be looking at that from that perspective as we go through your daily sessions in the chat, daily sessions in the main room, and of course, evening game plans. So here we are with the S&P down in terms of today's session, 2%. NASDAQ was off 2.5%. Dow futures also 2%, and the Russell down 1.5%. So I think the main thing to look at is going to be financials as we plot through this week. This week can still be fraught with surprises and additional selling, especially given how violent or volatile these red bars are on extremely high bear or liquidation volume. And there's always a consequence of cutting rates. It's nice that the Fed cuts rates. It's nice if interest rate policies stay at zero, because that means we can get houses cheaper and get all kinds of loans cheaper and finance, refinance, all that. But there are penalties and there are danger spots to keeping rates that low, and one of those is the financial sector itself. If the rates are at zero, how are the banks going to make money in lower interest rate environments? It may be good for the economy, but if it's not so good for financials, that's saying a lot. So in today's session, the stocks that took the biggest hit, at least the sector, was technology, strangely enough, right there with XLF as financials. And then E Energy took a hit as well, declining over 3%. The main thing to watch as we go through this week is, again, the spotlight on the financial companies. That includes Capital One, Bank of America, Bank of New York Mellon, American Express, MasterCard, and others. Morgan Stanley and U.S. Bank, etc. Even Goldman Sachs. And this is just in the S&P 100. There are the names in the financial sector to keep watch on. Let's take a look at some of those. For Capital, just taking a look at how the percent change went. Capital One took the biggest hit of the stocks in the S&P 500, followed right there with it, with Bank of America. So these stocks are now breaking key support levels and pulling up to a weekly chart perspective has taken us all the way back to this sideways consolidation or rectangle period last seen from 2019. Really in 2018 as well. And Bank of America, or Capital One Financial, same as Bank of America. And American Express, it was stronger, but that's right back to our 105, 110 pivot zone. And others include MasterCard, strong like American Express, but back into the zones there. And a few others just by, again, percent change today. Morgan Stanley, all this gains or all the gains have been taken away, and the focus remains on financials. But not just financials, because technology, XLK, this is again as a weekly chart, is unfocused as well. So that is another sector that is weak on today's liquidation event session when the Fed did their emergency rate cut, which I think should have been bullish. The fact that it's not bullish is a big sign. So beyond that, we're looking at Facebook, which is back down to this 180 region, back to where we were the last few years. And we're looking at Microsoft, a leading stock that had the overshot the growth rate, these rising parallel trend lines, and we're back to the 160. So a lot of damage has been done on daily charts. Profits have been made on the short side, on the defensive side, or financial gains have been lost on the bull side. We know at TheoTrade that which goes up and that which goes strongly up cannot go up forever. So we're back to this normal growth rate, and these stocks are and remain in focus, and that includes ExxonMobil, which broke support, FedEx, a transportation stock, Starbucks, and others. This COVID, this disease, this virus that we're, you know, the pandemic or epidemic, that is in focus, and it's mainly in focus from the perspective of financial. There's a lot of ways we can talk about it, but just in terms of the Fed and just keeping it within today's parameters, it's going to slow or recess some economic growth that's happening in China, Japan, supply avenues and shortages in products. Apple is part of that as well. And businesses will and are losing revenue. So the Fed has stepped in part to blunt some of those transactions or blunt some of the financial losses from reduced travel or reduced consumer spending, reduced population centers in terms of malls or open air spaces, even sports arenas. You're seeing some places in Italy play sports or play football or soccer games in empty arenas. So this is getting global. It's certainly global, but it's getting into the financial markets where the Fed has acted, but the market has ignored or at least closed 2% lower. Well, that kind of underscores the point that the session was up, at least the S&P, into the 3140, the high of 3137, and that closed at the really 300 or 3000 level. So that is 140 points in the S&P, the S&P futures, that came off from when the Fed surprised us. I don't think it surprised us here at TheoTrade, thanks to Don's leadership with the Fed rate cut at any point in time. Didn't surprise us, but it probably surprised the bulk of the trading community. But the market did not react as expected, at least as a knee-jerk reaction, as in, yes, the Fed's going to save us. Yes, the Fed's got our back. Yes, the Fed is going to be the thing that pulls us out of this recession or the financial losses across the business sector. That was not reacted to today. So outside the equity market, always pull the perspective up to money flow or what else is happening. So gold, if the Fed is going to create inflation or provide stimulative monetary policy or cut rates, basically, that should be seen as a inflation creation event. If the Fed is going to create inflation, gold says, I'm right there with you, and I'm going to jump to the upside. So that's a trade to watch as well for bullish on gold, to the extent that financial policy or stimulative policy creates inflation or blunts some of the losses. Gold probably goes a lockstep or at least trades higher within that context. And we're already well up off these 2019 lows. So gold at one point, not too long ago, was at 1300 per ounce, stabilized at about 1450. That was some buy call trades or buy opportunities. We had some additional ones on the pullbacks or retracements, and gold traded up. I figured 1600 was a nice target. That overshot by $100 into 1700, and we're bouncing back up, probably to those levels and higher. And on the other side, VIX. Of course, the VIX jumped up today. We can take a look at it as it jumped, traded higher. And we can actually look at, there's the VIX. It peaked at 50, came down a little bit, but today's session, just volatile all around. So that's affecting option prices across the board, implied volatility, historical volatility, and of course your percentages or percent functions and percentile ranks. You're going to see hundreds sometimes across the board in major stocks. So that's just part of the volatility function. We haven't had volatility like this in a while, and it's affecting stocks across the board, which means options are more expensive for the purchase side. Beyond that, we look at ZN. And this is similar if you think about gold being a risk-off or protective type of market. So are bonds. So if the Fed's going to cut rates directly, if they're going to push rates to the downside, that's going to create a bullish effect in bond or note or treasury prices. Just like gold, we've been seeing that in 2009, saw stabilization in 2000, in later part of the 2009, and then bullishness into 2020. And that's playing out in ETFs such as TLT, IEF, and others. So bonds, or at least TLTs, peaked into the 16 or 160 per share on the ETF, and of course the 10-year and the 30-year. And as Don is reminding us in his sessions, the yield has pierced the 1% bound. I actually traded under that in today's session. The way we look at yields, we'll pull up to a weekly chart. These are Treasury yields, and the 3.2 represents 3.2%. The 3.0 represents 3.0%, and the 2.0 represents 2.0%, and so on. So given that the bond prices has been up, given the Fed has engaged in QE4, and now these rate-cutting policies, the yields, understandably, have traded lower. And now we have this break of a multi-year trend line and multi-year lows, and go back even further. We can take so many different perspectives on this, but yields have been going down over the last really decade and beyond that, and they just reached their 1% bound. So I'll let Don cover this in other videos in more detail, but that is something to be watching as yields break to new lows. And that's where the market is. The Fed wants it there. They want the stimulative policy of lower rates, and we're getting it, but that might not be enough. So always stay close, stay with the videos, stay with the evening updates and reports as we go through and guide you through these interesting times. Profitable for some traders and not for others, but we certainly have lots of information in the archives and videos and evening updates and daily sessions for you to keep in touch with, to keep with informed, and of course to create the trades on the swing or intraday basis. But as always, we are thinking protection, thinking risk beyond all. Profits come after that risk, and these are risky markets, risky times, but opportunities do abound. As always, stay careful and safe. This is Corey Rosenblum with your Theo at Nightly video for March 3rd, 2020.